What's up, guys? It's Strack, and I had to make a video about this. Now, if you watch my vlogs, you might have seen it. If I haven't made the vlogs, that's because I'm lazy. But this is the Highland Fang, and this was given to me by Big Al in Scotland. Now, Big Al is one of the major, I guess, pillars of the Scottish Nerf community. I think that that's pretty fair to say. I've gotten that impression from him. He constantly travels to conventions throughout the UK, and there's a decent chance that we will see him at Endwar this year. He is a prop maker and a costumer, and he also does a ton of stuff with custom Nerf guns. Now, what's really interesting is he does his own Hydra work. Out of all the Nerfers out there, there are very few people doing their own Hydra graphics work. I am one. I know that Project FDL just figured out how to do it themselves, so they've been doing their own stuff, but most people just skip it entirely, and that's because it can be a very tedious, very frustrating process. But I had to make a video thanking Al for this blaster, and there are a few other things that I want to say about it, and at the end we're going to have a fun contest. I don't even know what I'm going to give away quite yet, but I think it's going to be like a full swag pack. You'll get a Foam Dart Thunder buff, you'll get an Endwar bandana, and you'll get a couple of patches from me. But we'll talk about that in a second. So what this is the Rebel Secrets and Spies Strong Arm. I don't even remember what the Strong Arm was called necessarily, but it's of course still stock, which means that it performs fine. Honestly, it's got that translucent red barrel. And when I first saw this, I thought to myself, I was like, man, that'd be really cool to make it light up. But then I never did it because it was a Rebel blaster and I just didn't really have time. But all of the Rebel blasters have this awesome shell for hydrographics work because they sand up so nicely and they've got such smooth bodies. Now you can tell that Al also does prop making and cosplay because his dry brushing is on point. The dry brushing here with the like distressed brass is just awesome. And then of course he's redone this in red and the trigger as well. Now I don't think that the trigger on this was originally red, so I want to compliment him again. Painting triggers can be very, very difficult, but he did it and he did a fine job of it and it looks great. Now he has these chibi versions of himself. There's Al, there's the Monkeytron, and then there is Al's wife, Mel. And the Monkeytron Collective is like his company that he takes on the road to conventions. So if he comes to Endwar, it will be as Monkeytron. But the fellow that does his chibi figures also made a chibi Drek. And I am so flattered. Like, oh my goodness, it's got my shades, it's got my bandana, his hair is cool, he's carrying the Sauron Nemesis, boots, and a trench coat. And if that's not me to a T, I don't know what is. Now, I'm pretty sure exactly that this also has slam fire, so this is overall a sweet sidearm. However, down here we've got the Foam Dart Thunder logo, which is the event that I went up to participate in while I was in Scotland. And the cool thing about this is that it's also a secret reservoir for two extra darts, so that in and of itself is cool. But I'm not really reviewing the blaster's performance so much because it is still stock. It's just aesthetically gorgeous. Now in Scotland, the clans have tartan, but this is, I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, I think that this is the traditional Scottish tartan, which I've kind of adopted as the one that I will be using. And that'll make more sense when you see the photos from the December SCNC War, aka Decembwar. But the traditional Scottish tartan is, I think, black and red, and it's kind of got all of these different shades of those in it, and it looks a lot like this. So this is traditional Scottish tartan, I think. I want to say there's a specific clan that it's also associated with, but I don't really know the culture as well as I'd like to, and I'd like to go back to Scotland and learn more about it at some point because I really fell in love with Scotland. However, I don't want to speak too terribly much about it in this video because I know that everybody on the internet is an expert because they have Google at their fingertips, and somebody is going to tell me how stupid I am. But needless to say, I definitely really appreciated that Big Al picked out a tartan for me to use, and it's in my colors as well. This is just such a fine gift. Like, you very rarely get things passed to you that have this much uniqueness, like complete with a custom character, and that is so very, very cool. And as though that weren't enough, Al has a daughter named Kara, and Kara was so disappointed that I didn't get to go out and find Highland cows. I really wanted to meet a Highland cow because Highland cows are one of very few animals that also wear sunglasses all the time. So Kara got me this miniature Highland cow. So now I have my very own Highland cow all the time. I wonder if it'll connect to the Highland Fang. Nope, it's just a little too big, but that is the Highland Fang from Big Al, and the contest, which again has a modest prize of swag, and maybe I'll include a couple of other things. Typically when I ship packages out of my workshop, they come with goodies from the workshop, so I'll make it more interesting, but it guaranteed is going to come with a Foam Dart Thunder buff, an End War bandana, and a couple of patches. I'm going to post in the description box this chibi character that was done by Big Al's guy, and I will let you guys make memes out of it. Now, normally when people make memes, it is against my will and hurts my feelings. But this time, I feel like they could be really cool because I'm asking for it. So it's a meme contest, guys. Whoever makes the best meme with the Chibi Drac will get a package sent to them. I'll pay the shipping no matter where you are. Why not? Like, if you're in Malaysia, I'll pay shipping to Malaysia. That has stung in the past, but I would be happy to do it. So that is my review, or really just overview, and thank you for the Highland Fang. Again, in the description box, there will be a link to this image, as well as a link to the Monkeytron Collective Facebook page, where you can check out all of their wares. They do all sorts of cool props and functional props as well, and you can keep track of their convention schedule and commission them and what have you, because obviously they are capable of doing very high quality custom work on pretty much any level. This is so, so very flattering. So thank you very much to Big Al, thank you very much to Kara, and thank you very much to whoever enters into the meme contest. I will close it in a week after this video goes live. Much love, Nerf on, check out.